Hello everyone, I welcome you all to the second video lecture of this series. In this video lecture, I am going to talk about model organism used in genetics. But in this video, I will be talking about the second model organism, that is zebrafish or Denio. This is one of the most common and preferred organisms used in different genetic experiments as model. Apart from genetics, they are also used in other fields of research as well. This video is also an outcome of the hands-on workshop cum training program that was held in Daulat Ram College, University of Delhi, in association with Sanskriti Foundation under IQAC on 28 to 31st May 2019. So, to start with, what is the most important feature of Denio radio? Before that, what we'll learn after this video lecture? So, we'll know about important features that make zebrafish a good experimental model system in genetics, and we'll also know the applications of this model organism in different research fields. So, zebrafish are small freshwater fish commonly found in the tropics, although they are native to South Asia. They are among the most common aquarium fishes, found typically in shallow ponds, canals and streams. As omnivorous organisms, they feed on a range of organisms such as insects, worms and zooplankton, as well as various plant matters in the environment. Although zebrafish are not of economic importance as a source of food, they have become increasingly important in research studies as model system, though researchers are trying to understand the genetic and neuronal basis for behavior. As such, they are particularly important in developmental biology, biomedicine, and neurophysiology experiments. The name zebrafish comes from the blue stripes that run horizontally on each side of their bodies, as we can see in this picture. So these zebrafishes, they measure about 6 cm in length on an average. In addition to a moderately elongated body that gives them the classic fish shape, they have a mouth that forms slightly upwards and a dorsally compressed head. They lack oral tooth, but they have teeth attached to their fifth brachial arch consisting of a dentine layer and enamel coating as well as a pulp coat. They have two pairs of skin sensory appendages known as barbels. These include the rostral or nasal barbels that extend to the orbit's anterior margin and the long maxillary barbels on either side of the mouth that act as taste buds and are also used for search for food. Although zebrafishes are generally silvery white in color, they have about 5 horizontal lines, blue in color, on either side of their body extending to the caudal fin. Moreover, the upper or dorsal part and belly part may appear pale yellow in color, causing some zebrafish to appear more golden. These slides represent the classification of zebrafish. Zebrafish also shows sexual dimorphism, that is, the male and female can be distinguished morphologically. Female zebrafish tends to be larger in size with a rounded belly, whitish in color, while male zebrafish are more slender with a golden appearance on their belly. Males also have a golden appearance on their pelvic and ventral fin. Adult females have a small genital papilla located in front of the anal fin. Apart from this, a striped anal fin with between 10 and 12 branched rays and a dorsal fin with between 30 and 32 branched rays are also some of the anatomical features of zebrafishes. Coming over to the life cycle of zebrafish, on an average, zebrafish have a lifespan of 3.5 years. However, some live up to 5.5 years. As they age, zebrafish have been shown to portray a declining exercise capacity similar to mammals. This has been shown to be the case with performance and trainability of the organism as they age. These zebrafishes, they need some special conditions for breeding. Since the male and female are morphologically different, they can be distinguished with naked eyes. So breeding refers to the mating and consequently the production of offspring by given organisms. Successful breeding of zebrafish is a complex process that is influenced by many components such as abiotic factors of the environment, courtship, and various behavioral aspects among others. In order to achieve successful breeding, ideal housing conditions are essential. Some of the characteristics of ideal housing conditions are mentioned here, such as mechanical filters that remove large debris, activated carbon filters remove contaminants and small elements, biological filters remove organic waste, ultraviolet sterilizing unit, 14-hour lighting and 10-hour darkness cycle allows the fish to breed at dawn. The water temperature should be between 23 to 28 degrees Celsius and the pH of the water should be maintained between 6.2 and 7.5. A female fish can produce as many as several hundreds of eggs per spawning. Given that eggs are released to be fertilized externally, the production of this many eggs allows for many offspring to survive through the development process before they reach adulthood, even as some die in the process. The eggs about 0.7 mm in diameter are released on a substrate where they become activated and start undergoing developmental steps, although they are non-adhesive and tends to be released on unprepared substrate. The eggs of zebrafish have been shown to be activated by water even in case where they are not fertilized by male sperm. The unfertilized eggs do not develop beyond the first few cleavage process. Zygote are formed when the cells are fertilized. They may occur immediately as the eggs are released and fertilized or within a period of 72 hours. Fertilization is followed by cell division. In the cleavage phase, they may take between 40 minutes to 2 hours. You can see the life cycle of zebrafish along with the time intervals. These are not the accurate time intervals, but a probable time period that must be occurring at each developmental stage. During this, the cell division may result in between 16 and 44 cells as the embryo moves to the next phase. The cleavage phase in which cell division is experienced produces the blastula. This is a form of embryo resembling a hollow ball and contains many layers of cells that surround a cavity known as blastocoele. The next stage of development is known as gastrulation and results in the production of three germ layers and thus the body plan of the organism. Whereas blastula occurs between 2 and 5 hours after fertilization, gastrulation occurs between 5 to 10 hours following fertilization. This is followed by two other phases, namely segmentation and then pharyngular stage before hatching. In these two stages, structure of the organism develop further within the head and tail becoming more pronounced visible. This prepares the offspring for hatching. Hatching occurs between 48 to 72 hours after fertilization. This, however, has been shown to largely depend on the thickness of the chorion in which the embryo resides, as well as the muscular activity of the embryo. Depending on these factors, hatching of some embryo may be delayed. Once it is hatched, the larva measures about 3 mm in length. Using secretory cells located on the surface of its head, the larva attach to hard surface from where they grow using nutrients from the yolk. In a period of about 3 days, the larva undergoes morphogenesis, which is characterized by the development of various anatomical structures. By the late larval stage, about 7 days after fertilization, the organism is capable of swimming, moving its jaw, and even feeding on various food material. At the juvenile phase, between 2 to 10 weeks old, the organism is capable of eating small organisms such as small worms and shrimps. The juvenile can be kept with adult fish when they are in the late part of their juvenile phase and they reach maturity at about 10 weeks of the age. Once they mature, they are ready to reproduce and the life cycle continues. Although there are male and female zebrafishes, all first develop into ovaries before differentiating into male gonads a few weeks after hatching. During courtship period, the male uses a number of strategies to attract the female and lead her to the spawning site. These may include using his snout to nudge her, swimming around with her with his fins raised, or swimming back and forth between the female and the spawning site. In the event that the female follows to the spawning site, the male spreads his dorsal and caudal fins, aroused so that their genital pores align. This is followed by the female releasing the egg as the male releases the sperm cells to fertilize them. Now, this is a closer view of all the different developmental stages that occur in zebrafish. This is the fertilized egg, which consists of three components: yolk, single cell, and the chorion. Chorion is the protective layer. Then the cell division start, and 2 cell stage, 4 cell stage, 8 cell stage, 16 cell stage, etc. continues. Then this stage reaches the 1000 cell stage, and after 1000 cell stage, it reaches the mid-blastula stage. After mid-blastula stage, the gastrulation start. During gastrulation, the 3 germ layers are formed. Apart from 3 germ layers, different organs start forming after gastrulation. The firstmost organ to be formed is the eye. The eye develops, and after that the pigment cell of the eye and trunk region of the organism develops. In this picture you can see the pigments that is developed in different parts of the body. After this, the organism moves for the first time inside the chorion. The heartbeat can be seen, the movement of the blood cells can be seen. Once it reaches this stage, the larva becomes ready to hatch from the chorion, and depending on its muscular activity, this larva hatches from the chorion and becomes a free swimming organism. This larva then undergoes morphogenesis and forms the adult zebra fish. These are the same structural and developmental stages of zebrafish. These photographs are original photographs that has been taken during the workshop. So why zebrafish is used so much in research? They have a number of characteristics that have made them the most ideal organism for research purpose in field of genetics, developmental biology and neurophysiology, among others. They lay many eggs, which is ideal for research studies. They can be easily bred in laboratory. They are not expensive to breed. The transparent larva of zebrafish allow for easier imaging of their neuronal structure and function. Eggs are released and fertilized externally, thus making it easier to study or manipulate. From this early stage, they have been shown to carry highly conserved orthologous in their genome, resembling many of the genes associated with various human neurological disorders. About 70% of human genes can be found in zebrafish. So, genetic mutations in human beings have been associated with various conditions. However, a researcher may wish to determine whether any loss of function of the gene does indeed cause a condition observed in an individual. To do this, a similar gene is mutated in the fish to observe the outcome. In some cases, the mutated gene in the human being with the condition may be introduced into the DNA of the fish. Through such genetic studies, it would be possible to learn more about the condition and thus how to proceed. A number of human diseases have been successfully modeled in zebrafish. These include Duchenne muscular dystrophy, human melanoma, human neurodegenerative diseases. Although zebrafish have many advantages for modeling human diseases, some of the disadvantages include: they are not mammals and thus lack mammalian organs. Some of the disease caused by orthologous genes vary
significantly between human beings and fishes. The genome of zebrafish contains many gene duplications. With regards to regeneration, zebrafish have been shown to be capable of regenerating lost fins as well as a number of lesioned organs such as the retina, spinal cord, and the heart, among a number of other tissues. As a result, zebrafish has also become an excellent model for heart regeneration studies as well as animal aging research. So, these are some of the few videos that we recorded during this workshop, which shows different stages of the development of zebrafish. So, this video shows the breeding, how males and females breed with mate with each other, and how eggs are produced. The female is chased by the males, and then the mate and the females lay eggs, as well as the male lays the sperm and the eggs are fertilized. This video shows how after the eggs are laid, how they are collected for further studies. The eggs are filtered using a filter, and they appear to be shining, sparkling white in color. Then they are put up in a petri dish with a media with optimum conditions, and all the further development are observed on this petri plate at different time intervals. The eggs can be seen very clearly. So we start observing these eggs every half an hour and we record the observation. This video shows the gastrulation and further development of the embryo. This video very clearly shows the heartbeat of this growing embryo, the pigment cells, and movement of the blood cells inside the organism. And you can even attach manually, no problem. But then, if you want to see a dose-dependent thing, then manually dose to control karna becomes essential.
Right, which is how you know it's called.
Which is chemically, I believe, the instrument, micro-injection as a technique develop ho rahi hogi. So, ye instruments se pehle unhone manually kiya obviously.
The heartbeat can be seen very clearly here. So these are few YouTube links that can be used if you want to see more information related to zebrafish. I have also consulted these videos before making this video lecture. So this was all about zebrafish. Thank you and stay tuned for my next lecture that will also be on modern organisms in genetics, that is Caenorhabditis elegans. Thank you.